I have an admission to make, and one that I suspect will not be terribly popular. Of the many mithais our wonderful country boasts, the one that I do not love is one called Modak. So I was feeling a little bad for myself since I wasn't able to fully embrace the festive spirit right now, because of course for me festivity spells food. Help happily is at hand. I managed to track down a couple of supremely talented people who are choosing to do things just a little differently. You'll see.
Yes, I was headed to Studio 15 by Pastry Queen Pooja Dhingra, a space dedicated to sharing, learning and teaching all things culinary.
Hello.
So I ask you, where better to turn to when looking for some brand new Ganpati-based goodies?
I have to admit, I'm really excited actually about today. This is a festival whose, the mithai that represents it is embarrassingly enough one that I'm not a fan of. So I have come to the both of you seeking help.
Me as well, I'm not too big, I'm not a big fan of the traditional modak. So, you know, in our kitchen we always try and experiment and we try to do something different. So we're like, why don't we do, like, you know, take chocolate, because that's, I'm obsessive about it. Why don't we
chocolate.
So why don't we take chocolate and you know, have some fun with it. So we decided to do different fillings inside. So we're making chocolate modaks, both dark chocolate and white chocolate. And inside we're going to, you know, play around with some flavors.
This is sounding very good. Okay, now you?
We're doing something very contemporary.
Okay.
We're sticking with the very traditional covering.
Okay.
And we are stuffing it with baklava.
Oh.
So that's one, and the second one is again very traditional. There is gulkand and khoya.
So yay! What are we starting with?
So what we start with is the traditional covering of the modak,
right?
Which is usually rice flour,
okay,
and water.
So this is rice flour,
which is fragrant basmati rice, and which is grinded. What we do is equal parts of rice flour and water. We start with some water.
Right.
So the pan is hot already. We'll just wait for the water to boil. We'll add in a spoonful of ghee, which is traditionally sinful.
I really love the sort of difference between a civilian and a chef's use of a teaspoon.
Once the roll boil starts, which is ferocious boiling, we add in the rice flour and just cook it, and that's one part of the dough which is ready.
Okay.
Once that is ready, it requires a little bit of kneading because it's gluten-free. Rice is gluten-free, so it needs to develop that bit of
But tell me, is this principally the same? I'm sorry, this might be a mildly inappropriate question, but is this the same as like what you do for a dim sum wrapper?
It's similar. The only difference is the rice flour is glutinous in terms of a dim sum. They use the Japanese glutinous sticky rice, which, and they powder that. So
it probably binds.
So that's the difference. So this is a little, it's gluten-free basically.
Right.
So there we go. Goes in the rice flour. We have to be a little careful here.
It doesn't clump.
Okay. Now there goes in the partially cooked modak dough.
Cool, it smells good. I think probably best we take a few minutes to let it cool down. Pooja?
So I'm ready for you to follow and make this at home. Also, it's very easy. All you need to do is get some chocolate, a compound chocolate or like a cooking chocolate. So I'll basically, just because, I mean, the main flavor is going to come from the filling that we put in. So even if you use a compound chocolate for this, it's perfectly fine. It's also very easy to work with. So all you need to do is just melt it. So we've just taken approximately like 250 grams of dark chocolate. We've put it inside a bowl and we've just melted it. Once it's all nice and smooth and silky like that, we're going to take it off. As you can see, it's still very hot, it's steaming, right? So what we need to do is just let it cool down a little bit, come down to room temperature.
Okay.
That'll take a couple of minutes. And once that's done, we're just going to pick up a mold. So what we've done is, we've got these little modak molds here. So while this cools down a little bit, I'll just show you, we'll make a couple of the fillings. So like I said, we're going to make two fillings. One is with coconut, because that, you know, when you think of like Maharashtrian festivals, you think of a lot of coconut. So we're going to use fresh coconut.
Ooh.
And one is pistachio. And then you can, you know, once you know how it's done, you can use any combination of flavors, okay? So what we've done is we've just taken some white chocolate and we're going to boil some cream, okay? So this is just your regular cooking cream.
So like any like
Tetra Pak cream, exactly.
Yeah.
What we're looking for is like that one first proper boil. The key is to just keep whisking it when you're doing it so that the bottom doesn't burn. And then just pour it over your chocolate. So you can see that it's boiling, right?
Yeah.
And we take our white chocolate and just pour the cream on it. Okay, so essentially what we're doing is we're creating an emulsion. So we want fat from the chocolate and the cream to come together. We have to be very careful with it. So we're going to start making really small circles. We're going to put our whisk right in the bottom and we're going to just start whisking it. We're not going to keep lifting the whisk up because that will add air into it. The more air you get in, the more humidity kind of ruins your chocolate. And so what we're going to do is just make small circles in one place. And you see that it'll slowly come together.
Yeah.
This is just cocoa butter, right? White chocolate.
It's basically imitation chocolate. So it's just cocoa butter milk solid.
As long as there's chocolate in the sentence, I don't care.
So this is like a basic paste filling that we made.
Okay.
And now you can use this as a base and put anything in it. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a small bowl. Take fresh grated coconut. And we're just going to mix in some with this. You can eat this just like that with a spoon.
Sure.
That's a problem, right? Working in the kitchen.
That's the pista one.
So our fillings are done, ready. That was easy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And now the next step is also very simple. We're just going to take our molds. Okay. Varun can do the dark chocolate and I can do the white. All we're going to do is we're just going to take spoonfuls of the chocolate and just cover the entire thing up. You could use a piping bag to do this, will be faster, but if you're doing it at home.
Yeah. I've already made mine untidier than yours.
That's okay, we're going to clean it up, don't worry.
She's not dribbled one thing. What?
Next. So we're just going to wait a little bit for this, and then what we're going to do is we're just going to overturn it.
I think I should try the white chocolate just to make sure that's delicious.
As please, well. Go for it. Yeah, we have to make sure, right?
It's only fair, right? Oh, thank you.
Everything okay?
You know, I think maybe I need a few more bites to be sure. I'm kidding, it's fab.
So we need to wait a couple of minutes
till
this sets slightly. Okay. So what I want is I want the outside coating to be firm, but the inside will still be soft. So when we turn it over, you know, just the liquid from the center will come off. So you could like put this in the fridge for 30 seconds, 1 minute to kind of speed the process, but we won't do that. In the meantime, chef will show you how to make
both.
Yes. While we wait.
I should probably wash my hands if I'm going to get my paws in there. All right. More the time.
What we do now is this just needs a little bit of kneading.
Okay.
So we'll hand knead it while you can do it in a processor.
Can I get my hands in there?
Please
I wash
do.
Them in everything.
Please do.
It feels nice. It smells good. I'm not trying to get air in or anything.
Not at all. It just needs to get together and it just needs to be like a dough, basically.
Okay.
It needs to be pliable.
Alright.
Can I?
Yeah.
If it's drying a little, we'll just take a little bit more water.
Okay.
Right?
Go for it,
Anisha. Yeah. I'm wondering how to transform this and stuff it with shrimp and make dim sum out of it.
You still
stuck on that.
You'll get some sweet dim sums here, by the way.
Yeah.
So it's Maharashtra's take on dim sums, yeah?
I agree. Gluten, by the way, for the uninitiated, is
the protein in the grain.
Okay. Proteins are nature's fat burners, isn't it?
So this is like the crude form of protein. So there we are done with the outer filling, outer covering.
Neater than when I was trying to mold it, kneaded.
So you can see the difference now when it was in the pan and now when we've worked on it.
Okay.
Looking.
Perfect. So now what?
So we're done there.
All right. So we start rolling. Oh no, chocolate decanting. Yes.
So what I'm going to do is just do. You can see we have a coating. Alright, so I'm just gonna just clean it up a little bit. Alright, so we got this, and now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take a little bit of our fillings. So we can actually use any filling. We could probably even use the baklava filling for this.
No, why not? Oh, I like it. We have four brand new options and from this four another, you know.
Alright, do you wanna, so you could, you know, essentially you could put this in the fridge for a couple of minutes just let it rest.
Okay.
Or since, you know, we're just going to, again, like we're just focusing on the filling, not so much of what's going on there. We're just going to put in a pistachio filling. So this is just a pistachio with white chocolate again.
No,
and then you just cover it with the chocolate and you're done. Yeah,
just cover it with chocolate, my favorite words. Guess what? My hands are chocolatey all over again.
And then that goes into the fridge.
That goes into the fridge?
And then, yeah.
Boom, we're done. All right, perfect. So, since there is a lot of melted chocolate around and since it anyway needs to chill and since there's nuts and other kinds of deliciousness, I think we're going to take a break. When we come back, Modak, but Modak like you've never seen it before.